drive it in deep. Dingman after it. He was bumped. Getting rough again out there. Now Dingman is nailed again by O'Donnell. Gets it back. They score. And it's not finished yet. O'Donnell gets up swinging.
O'Donnell and Dingman are fighting. The score is 5-0. So this fight is a waste of everybody's time. These guys are tired. And the game's over.
O'Donnell kept coming after Dingman. Finally, they fall, and the linesman now will have to persuade them somehow to get apart. Forget about it. 2:24 left in the third. They will now go and forget about it. It is 5-0.
I don't think Dingman or O'Donnell even knew the goal was scored, as they were behind the net mixing it up when the puck went in. Let's have a look at the goal. We've showed you the scrap. And it is 5-0. Again, the Avalanche. Hard to handle in the offensive zone, the third and fourth lines especially. Reinprecht deflects it off Brodeur, who's very surprised it went in. Here's a better look. As it hit between the legs of Martin Brodeur and bounced in as Reinprecht scores with 2:24 to go in the hockey game to make it 5-0. But they're going upstairs to check this out for some reason. They have not put the goal up on the board. And is there some doubt as to whether it went in or not? And that's what I think they're trying to find out. Andy Van Helleman is the supervisor. So they just want to double check and see whether it went in. It's a weird goal. Here it is here. And maybe we can show you. There it is, over the line, just by about the width of a puck.
So Martin has scored on for the fifth time in this first game. And the referee will now get the message from upstairs and point to center ice, and the crowd will cheer.
Brodeur has only allowed 4-plus goals twice in these playoffs. 6-5, Toronto, 4-2, Pittsburgh. Now watch behind the net, as here's where the problem arises. O'Donnell jumps on Dingman, and then as they get up, they decide they're going to have a little dance. Not a lot of damage done in the fight. The damage was done before the fight by Reinprecht, who came up behind the net, somehow slipped it by Martin Brodeur.